My friend just got a PS5, and they've been blown away by the improvements in 3D sound. Playing the Demon's Souls remaster, they told me, it sounded almost exactly like it should. The PS5 has a new system that Sony's calling Tempest 3D AudioTech. That means that they're not using Dolby Atmos, an existing and proprietary technology for 3D audio, but rather they've built their own system from scratch, including the processing hardware of the PS5 itself. Right now, at launch in November 2020, the 3D audio system only works with headphones, not speakers. But, impressively, their system works with any headphones, and you don't need any additional hardware. How does this work? Well, the PS5 is converting locations of 3D sound objects into binaural audio in real time. Now, I've talked about binaural audio a bit in a previous video. Binaural audio is two-channel audio specifically designed for headphones. But the PS5 has some interesting settings that give me an opportunity to speak a little bit more about HRTF, head-related transfer function. To simplify, let's start by talking about one ear, your right ear, for example. Just listening with this ear, as sounds go around your head, they will sound different. This makes sense, right? Sounds on the left side of your head don't go directly to your right ear. They have to actually pass through your head in order to reach your eardrum, in addition to reverberating off the walls and things like that. Traveling through your head makes sounds quieter, and it also affects the frequency spectrum. For example, high frequencies likely won't travel through your head as well as lower frequencies, so the sounds will be more muffled. In addition to our head, there's also our pinna, our outer ears. Our ears are funny-looking satellite dishes on the sides of our head. They have all sorts of bumps and grooves in them, and each of those bumps and grooves affects the frequency spectrum and amplitude of sounds before they reach our ear canal. You can graph this head-related transfer function, HRTF, as sounds go around your head, mapping changes in frequency spectra at a particular position. Importantly, our ears and their special shapes give us information about whether sounds are forward or back, since these satellite dishes point at a certain angle, and also up and down, as these sounds bounce off the detailed shapes of our ears. Now, if that makes sense, let's think about two ears. When we do that, we're working with two different HRTFs, one for each ear. So, with two ears working together, the same sound will sound different to your ears based on where it's located. A sound at the left front up has a different amplitude and spectrum in our left ear than right ear, and so on. Additionally, since the sound will travel different distances to each ear, there's a minute time difference too, the ITD, interaural time difference. What's important here though is everyone's ears and heads are different. Head width is not uniform across all people, and neither is the shape and size of our pinna. So each of us has learned over, well, however long we've been alive, how to interpret these changes of amplitude, frequency, and timing into 3D location of sounds. Back to the PS5 now, again, the Tempest 3D AudioTech is recreating these HRTF and interaural differences based on where sounds are happening in relation to the player. They're taking these sounds that are occurring in 3D space, filtering them, changing the amplitude, and changing the timing between two ears based on their virtual location. And they're doing this for all of the sounds that are occurring in the game world. All of the individual enemies, all of the other individual point sources. The Tempest engine can apparently spatialize hundreds of sounds, processing binaural HRTFs in real time. But remember, everyone's ears and heads are different. So, if everyone has a different HRTF, how do you make binaural 3D audio that works for everyone? The short answer is, you can't. Sony's short-term solution has been to have, in the settings, five different options that you can choose from. These are likely five default HRTFs, either from people or extrapolated with AI, that you can choose between and find a kind of best fit. They won't be your ears, but you can try to find ears that are close enough. Now, I don't work for Sony, I don't have any inside information, so I don't really know what's going on here, but they're labeled as higher and lower, so I'm guessing that Sony is prioritizing the up and down aspect of the HRTF over the other dimensions. This makes some sense because left and right spatial clues are a bit more straightforward, but I want to be clear here that this is just my guess. Moving forward, Sony seems to have lofty plans for increasing the accessibility and universality of this technology.
Maybe you'll be sending us a photo of your ear and we'll choose a neural network to pick the closest HRTF in our library. Maybe you'll be sending us a video of your ears and your head and we'll make a 3D model of them and synthesize the HRTF. Maybe you'll play an audio game to tune your HRTF. We'll be subtly changing it as you play and home in on the HRTF that gives you the highest score, meaning that it matches you the best.
Why does this matter? Well, let's consider esports. Will players with ear and head shapes closer to default PlayStation options have an advantage? If so, is that fair? It does appear that, given time, you can actually learn to localize sounds based on someone else's HRTF, in the same way that you learn to localize sounds based on your own. But what does this mean in terms of immersion if you're playing PlayStation with a different set of ears than you have in the real world? And of course, decoding 3D sound for speakers in different channel configurations is different too, and not necessarily related to HRTF. And it will be interesting to see how Sony delivers on the potential of Tempest moving forward.